So far in this series of DBMS lectures, we have discussed what is first, second, third and BCNF, all the normal forms, right? Although if a relational schema is given, then by default that would be in first normal form. So that is not an important concept, because when we convert an ER diagram into relational schema, then always we create a separate table for multi-valued attribute. So definitely that relational schema would be in first normal form. So the important concepts are second, third and BCNF, right? So these concepts we have already discussed with the help of examples, that a particular, what is second normal form, what is third, what is BCNF, and how to identify that a particular relation, particular given relation is in second, third and BCNF, all the rules and requirement for a relation to be in those normal forms, right? So now we have, I have discussed with simple examples, right? Just to get you familiar with the, you know, basic concept of these normal forms. But you will find out some, you know, tricky questions also in gate and net. It's not very easy that after looking the dependency, you can easily find out there is partial dependency or not, there is transitive dependency or not. No, they'll give some tricky questions. So it's better to solve some tricky questions as well, right? So here in this video, I'll solve two or three tricky questions, right? It's better you practice more and more questions if you are preparing for NET or GATE or any competitive, you know, exam. Because if you think that I know what is second, third and BCNF, I have already, practiced one or two questions and I'll directly solve this in the exam, then definitely maybe you can solve that question in exam correctly, but you will, you know, need more time if you will not practice. And if you will practice more and more, then within 15 seconds or 20 seconds, you can easily get by looking at that relation, that this, the what is the highest normal form of that relation. Fine. So it's very important to practice these questions, more and more questions. Fine. So let us revise quickly those normal forms. See how you can draw these normal forms. Something like this. Here we have BCNF. This is more strict than 3NF, right? 3NF is more strict than 2NF, and 2NF is more strict than first NF. Something like this in a Venn diagram, right? So now, see, previously, I think in June 2019 in GATE NET exam, this question was asked, if a relation is given in BCNF, if R is in BCNF, then which of the following statement is true? And statements was, so these were the four statements, and definitely by looking at this diagram, you can say if a relation is in BCNF, then definitely that would be in second NF and third NF, right? So this statement, this would be the right answer. How you can relate it? See, suppose this is what Gurgaon, this is what you can say Haryana, this is India and this is Asia. So definitely if I'm in Gurgaon, so you can say that definitely I'm in Haryana, I'm in India, right? But if I say that I'm in Haryana, so you cannot say that definitely I would be in Gurgaon, right? Maybe I can be in another city of Haryana. So here you can say if a relation is in third NF, so what you can say, that relation would definitely be in second NF, but we cannot say that that relation would definitely be in BCNF. That may or may not be in BCNF. If I am in Haryana, I may be in Gurgaon, I may not be in Gurgaon, right? So I think now you can get, if a relation is in second NF, then you can say that relation must be in first NF, but may or may not be in 3NF and BCNF, we can't say. But a relation is in BCNF, then that relation must be in 3NF, in 2NF and in first NF. So sometimes they can ask you these type of simple questions. So you should know these kind of things, right? So now we will discuss two or three questions, and after that I'll tell you some important points about, you know, that second NF, third NF and BCNF also, right? We will discuss tricky questions. So this is the question, and here you need to tell what is the highest normal form of this relation. See, what are the steps to find out the highest normal form? Obviously you will check, it's better to check for first of all the highest one, that BCNF, then 3NF, then 2NF, right? Maybe somewhere you find that it's better to check 2NF than 3NF, BCNF, it's up to you. But according to me, it's better to check for the highest normal form first of all. Why? So I'll tell you later. Now see, For finding out this, you need candidate keys, all the candidate keys. So first step is you need to find out all the candidate keys exist in this relation, right? Second step is find out prime attribute, non-prime attribute. Third step is check out the rules and regulations for the normal forms, right? First for BCNF, on for each functional dependency, right? That thing we'll discuss. Now, see how to find out candidate keys. That also I have discussed in the previous videos. The trick, the simplest trick to find out all the candidate keys. So you can check out that video in the I button, right? So now I recommend you to, you know, watch the previous videos. First of all, I'll provide you the link of all the videos, that DBMS playlist, in the description box. I recommend you to do not watch directly this video, right? First of all, check out those videos, then come to this video, then you will get it better. So now, how to find out candidate keys? See, candidate key is minimal super key. So first of all, take all the attribute, and the attribute closer will contain all the attributes definitely. So this is what super key. Now try to discard as many elements as you can. See, how to discard? Using functional dependencies. ABC can determine DE. Do you have ABC? Yes, I have ABC, so I can determine DE easily, right? So I can discard DE here. If you have ABC, then you can determine DE also. What's the point to write here DE? Now, sometimes you discard element something like this. After checking the second one, E determine GH, but we don't have E, so we cannot discard GH. H can determine G. We have H, so I can discard G, fine. G can determine H, but I don't have G. So now ABCD can determine EF, but I don't have D. Complete ABCD can determine EF, but I have only ABC. So now I cannot discard this F. So now you will say that we have ABC, F and H. Now I cannot discard any attribute. Still it is having what? 5 attributes, and this proper subset would be 2^5 - 2. So it's not easy to check all the proper subset. So that trick is not working here, but that's not a case. How you will discard these elements? See, when you will practice more and more, then you will get it better. ABC can determine DE, so I can discard DE. Now, E can determine GH, but I don't have E, you will say. But see, ABC can determine DE. So if you have ABC, then by default you have D and E as well, right? In the attribute closure. So if you have E, so you can derive GH. So from here you can discard GH also, right? Now, how you can discard anything else? H can determine G, but we have discard both G and H, fine. Now, see, ABCD can discard E and F. Now, you will say that we don't have D, so we cannot discard this F, right? But yes, we have D. How? Because see, ABC can determine both D and E. We have ABC. So definitely, by default, indirectly, I have D and E. And I have both ABCD, E, all the 4 attributes, then I can derive E and F. So here you can discard this F also, right? So remaining is only A, B and C. Now you can check, because here we have I guess only 6 proper subset, and if still you don't want to check all the 6, then one more trick is what? See, just check out the right hand side of each functional dependency and write down the attributes D, E, G and H, G, H, E and F, E and F. Using all the functional dependencies, we can derive these attributes. We cannot derive A, B and C. But a candidate key is able to, you know, uniquely identify all the attributes. Definitely the attribute closure of a candidate key should contain all the attributes, because candidate key is what? Minimal super key. So there must be ABC also. So right side must be ABC. So to put ABC to the right hand side, you must have ABC to the left hand side, because then only using reflexivity you can get ABC here. So definitely left hand side in candidate key ABC must present, right? Maybe with this ABC you can have D or E or something like this. I'm not saying that only ABC would be there, but this thing I can say that clearly, that ABC must be present in the candidate key, right? So here we have what? ABC. So you cannot discard any attribute from here. So definitely no proper subset can identify all the attribute of this relation, no proper subset of ABC. So definitely that would be super key as well as candidate key. I hope I'm able to convey this point to you, right? or if you are not getting this point, then you can find out the proper subset of ABC and you can check like AB, BC and AC, and you can check that any one of the proper subset is super key or not. If not, then this would be candidate key. But now this would definitely be candidate key. So we got one candidate key. So prime attributes are A, B and C. Now check out still more candidate keys are present or not. How to check prime attributes are, check available on the right hand side of functional dependency or not. No, neither A nor B nor C is present on the right hand side. So it means there are no more candidate keys, only one candidate key is there in this relation, and prime attribute are ABC. And non-prime attributes are D, E, F, G, H. We are done with two steps. Now find out. First of all, I'll check for BCNF. Check for each functional dependency. Now for BCNF, left hand side must be super key, right? Nothing else. The one condition is there. Is ABC super key? Yes, ABC is candidate key. Definitely that is super key. So this is satisfying, this FD is satisfying BCNF property. Is E super key? No, E is not super key. If you want to check out, then you can check out the attribute closure of E. If it contain all the attributes, then it would be super key. But E closure can derive E, G, H. Using H, I can derive G, but I have both G and H, nothing else, right? So it is not super key. Is H super key? No. G super key? No. How to find out? You can find out the attribute closure of H and G. Then you can get it is not super key. But here also you can say that it is not a super key. Why so? Because left hand side, for being a super key, left hand side must contain ABC, right? That point I have already discussed. And here we don't have ABC. Now here ABCD. See, this is super key. Because ABC is candidate key. Definitely that is super key. So if you add any more attribute with this ABC, so definitely that would be super key, right? Or if you want to check out, then you can find out the attribute closure of this one. That would contain all the attributes. So now this is not in BCNF because these functional dependencies are not satisfying BCNF property. Now check for 3NF. If this is in BCNF, definitely this would be 3NF. Definitely that would be in 3NF. Check out for these one. This functional dependency E to GH. For 3NF, what you should check, there should be no transitive dependency. So how you can check this one? Either left hand side is super key or right hand side is prime attribute. At least one condition must satisfy, then only we can say that this is in 3NF. This functional dependency is satisfying 3NF properties. Check. Is E left hand side is super key? No. Now check for second one. Directly we cannot say that this is not in 3NF. Is GH prime attributes? No. Now you can say that it is not satisfying 3NF properties, right? H left hand side is super key? No. G is prime attribute? No. So it is also not satisfying 3NF property. G is left hand side is super key? No. H is prime attribute? No. So it is not in 3NF. Second NF, first check for this one. This would be definitely in second NF. This would definitely be in second NF. I have already discussed with the help of diagram. Check for these one. ABC. For second NF, we check partial dependency. If partial dependency is there, then that is not in second NF. What is partial dependency? Proper subset of candidate key determines known prime attribute. Check. Is ABC proper subset of candidate key? No. Definitely that I can say that this is in BCNF. BCNF, then it is in second normal form. So now check for second one. Is E proper subset of candidate key? Candidate key is ABC? No. So no need to check the right hand side, because for partial dependency, left hand side must be proper subset of candidate key, right hand side must be known prime attribute. But this is not proper subset of candidate key, so we cannot say that this is partial dependency. If partial dependency is not there, then definitely it is satisfying 2NF property. Is H proper subset of candidate key? No. So it is also satisfying 2NF property because it is not partial dependency. Is this one G to H, is G proper subset of candidate key? No. So it cannot be partial dependency, so it is also satisfying 2NF property. Now you can say that, see, all the functional dependencies are satisfying 2NF property, so this relation is in 2NF. The highest normal form for this relation is 2NF. So I have taken this example just to show you how to discard elements properly, right? More and more elements. Now we will take one tricky questions in the terms of functional dependencies, then we will check the highest normal form for that question. So in this question you will definitely get something new, some new points about dependencies, maybe partial or transitive dependency. I can't say anything, but let's discuss it. First of all, find out the candidate keys, right? Take all one attribute closer. Now try to discard elements. AB can discard, AB can determine CD, so you can discard CD because we have AB. Now see here also, now you will say if AC can determine BD, so I can discard AC, because if you have AB, then definitely you have C, and you have both A and C, so you can discard B and D. So here you can discard B and D. Now you are left with A, but this is not correct. Why so? Because for identifying, for determining C, you need both A and B. This thing you need to take care, the initial point you need to take care. What is the requirement? So I cannot discard B. If you don't have B, then how can you discard C? How can you determine C? And if you don't have C, then how can you determine B and D? So we cannot discard B and D. So here we cannot discard this one. So you need to take care these points. Here we cannot discard B, because for determining C, we need both A and B, right? So now I guess I cannot discard anything else in this case. So now I am left with AB. So AB is super key. So is it candidate key or not? How to check? Check out the proper subset of this are candidate key or not. But A can determine only A, B can determine only B. So this is not super key, this is not super key. It means candidate key. AB is candidate key. It means prime attribute you have A and B. How to check more candidate keys are there or not? Prime attributes are present on the right hand side of any dependency or not? Yes, here we have B is present on the right hand side of this dependency, right? A is not present anywhere. So now at the place of B in the existing candidate key is AB. So here you replace this B with AC. It means we are having now A and C, right? Obviously we will not write AAC. So check out as AC is candidate key or not. A at and C closer. A closer is not super key. C closer, using C I can determine only C, so this is not super key. So definitely AC is candidate key. So one more prime attribute we have, that is C. Is C present on the right hand side of anything? Yes, this dependency, here we have C. So at the place of C in this candidate key, you can replace AB. So if you replace AB, then you will get AB, but we have already discussed that AB is candidate key, so no need to replace it. So now here we have only two candidate keys, AB and AC, and prime attribute ABC. Now, non-prime attributes are D. Now check for BCNF first of all. Is AB a super key? Yes. So this is satisfying BCNF property. Is AC super key? Yes, because it is candidate key, definitely it is a super key. Is BC a super key? No. It is not a super key. Why so? You can check out the attribute closer of BC. It will drive BC. Using BC, I can derive D. Now I cannot drive anything. So I cannot drive A here. It is not containing all the attributes. So BC is not a super key. Or by looking at this also, you can say, see the right hand side is containing C, D, BD, and D we have already written. So using these dependencies, I can determine BCD, but I cannot determine A. So for a key to be super key or a candidate key, left hand side must, that candidate key must contain A. With A, it can contain either B, C or D, that we have already discussed. With A, it is containing B and it is containing C, but definitely that would contain A. But BC is not containing A, so it cannot be a super key, right? 3NF, check for 3NF. This would be 3NF, this would be definitely in 3NF. Check for this one. Is it transitive dependency or not? Left hand side is super key? No. Now check right hand side. Right hand side prime attribute? No. So this is what? Violating 3NF property. So this is also not in 3NF. Now check for 2NF. This would be definitely in 2NF and this would also be in 2NF. Now check for this one. Is it a partial dependency? Partial dependency, then that is not in 2NF. Is BC a proper subset of candidate key? Here check, this is very important point. Here B is proper subset of this candidate key and C is proper subset of this candidate key. So it is union of proper subset of one candidate key and another candidate key. Now definitely you guys will say this is not, you know, a proper subset of candidate key, right? Because it should be proper subset of only one candidate key, but it is different and it is different. But that is wrong. This is what it is considered as proper subset of candidate key, right? So this point is very important. You should note this point, that is proper subset of one candidate key union proper subset of another candidate key. That would definitely be considered as proper subset of candidate key. Here it's not like that, proper subset of 1 and 2 only, maybe proper subset, maybe union of 3 candidate keys, here maybe proper subset of another candidate key, or union of maybe proper subset of 4 candidate key, right? That would definitely be considered as proper subset of candidate keys, right? Because this question has been asked in previous GATE exam, and many students attempted this question wrong, right? Because of this only. So this is definitely a proper subset of candidate key. Now check out right hand side, because right hand side must be now non prime attribute. Is D non prime? Yes. So this is partial dependency. If partial dependency is there, then that is not in second NF. So the highest normal form for this relation is only first NF, because by default we consider that every relation schema is in first NF. Still, we are left with some more tricky questions that we will discuss in next video. Now I am going to write down some important points about these normal forms. So these are three important points about these normal forms, that if all the candidate keys of a relation are simple, simple means these are having only single attribute. If the candidate key is having more than one attribute, then it is composite candidate key, right? If all the candidate keys are simple, then definitely that relation would be in second NF. Why so? Because there would be no partial dependency, because there would be no proper subset of candidate key possible. If no proper subset of candidate key is possible, then definitely there would be no partial dependency, right? Second one is, if all the attributes of a relation are prime attributes, then definitely that relation is in third normal form. Then blindly you can say that relation is in third normal form. If all the attributes are prime attributes. Why so? Because right hand side will always be containing a prime attribute if all the attributes are prime attribute. And for third normal form, either left hand side must be super key or right hand side must be prime attribute. So that would definitely be in 3NF. And now if relation is in 3NF and all the candidate keys are simple, then definitely that would be in BCNF, right? So now I'll discuss some more tricky questions in the next video. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.